Frye, a pleasure to see you.
Nice talks.
Miss Frye. I brought some books. I hope I'm not intruding by being here.
Quite the contrary. It's nice to have the company. A herbarium? Are you collecting flowers for someone?
Only myself. I'm told it's something of a British pastime. Did you know, they all have symbolic meanings?
I had heard something of the sort.
Of course you have. Unfortunately, I have no time to fill the book.
I could collect some samples. If you would accept my help.
I would appreciate that. Thank you, Miss Frye.
You look deadly with a cane.
Mr. Frye, I trust that you had a productive meeting with Mr. Owen.
Oh, yes, we had a most wonderful chat. I found out the man behind Staric's soothing syrup is John Elliotson.
Dr. Elliotson, I haven't heard that name in a long while. He was a brilliant heart specialist until he became obsessed with phrenology and mesmerism. It ruined his career. Well, how shall we proceed?
Oh, with all respect, Mr. Darwin, I believe I should proceed alone. After all, we wouldn't want to attract any unwanted attention.
Sounds very wise. Good luck, my boy. Oh, and Mr. Frye, should you find yourself with any free time, please do call on me.
Thank you. Where would I find the doctor?
As you've just witnessed, the application of too much pressure can sometimes result in unexpected outcomes. Unfortunately, it appears I've ruined the organ. Send up a cadaver.
At once, Dr. Litson.
I don't care about your ethics, and I care even less about your damn patience. Now hand over your keys.
What are you doing?
Haven't you heard? You're fired. Now bugger off.
How to do it. What's the matter?
Oh, young man, help. I must speak with Miss Nightingale at once. One of the brutes stole my key, and there's no one around. I can't get out of here.
Stole your key? Don't go anywhere. I might be able to do something.
Oh, quite. Thank you, sir. Well, you'll know where to find
me. I wouldn't trust the doctors here. Especially that Elliotson.
Elliotson cannot be allowed to continue his experimentations. I need to Nurse Nightingale. She will know what to do. His experimentations are making our patients worse. I am sure of it.
And said she was fired.
The bugger.
My gratitude, sir. I shall inform Miss Nightingale that I will not be working for the society.
Last it ends. Yet I can only think of beginnings. A better tomorrow, forged with the blood of visionaries.
All I see is the blood of a lunatic.
Do you truly believe murdering an old man will stop humanity's great architect? Crawford Starrick has a glorious design for mankind.
Designs are meant to be broken.
You're a child. A child who believes it can solve all the world's woes with a flick of a blade. Have you ever pondered the consequences of your actions, Jacob Frye? Or did your father teach you nothing?
That's a girl. Doing fine, girl.
And expired, and soothing syrup production has ceased. Outrageous!
Frye intends to endanger all of London at the hands of the mob.
Or perhaps it doesn't intend much of anything at all.
Thank you.
Simply content to dice with our lives.
The asylum is shut up. Medical care throughout the city is in disarray. He does not, cannot understand the consequences of his actions. The man is clearly an anarchist.
Gentlemen. This tea was brought to me from India. By a ship. And up from the harbor to a factory. Where it was packaged and ferried by carriage to my door. Unpacked in the larder and brought upstairs to me. All by men and women who work for me. Who are indebted to me. Crawford Starrick. For their jobs, the time, the very lives they lead. They will work in my factories, and so too shall their children.
And you come to me with talk of this Jacob Frye. This insignificant blemish who calls himself assassin? You disrespect the very city that works day and night so that we may drink this. This miracle, this tea.
I'm nearing the end of my research. Our beloved London shall not suffer such a bothersome fool for much longer.
And what of this sister I've heard of? Miss Frye.
Miss Frye shall be gutted. Soon enough. Delicious.
Sorry to interrupt, Initiate. Thought you'd like to know that Sean and Rebecca got away from Otzoberg. Berg runs a unit called Sigma Team. Violet DaCosta is his tech support. They've been hunting and killing assassins for a long time. Thank God you're all right.
Oh, tish tosh. It'll take more than a Templar super soldier to end the glorious saga of Sean Danger Hastings.
I was talking to Rebecca.
Right. Anyway, Berg's presence confirms it. The Peace of Eden is in London.
The Initiate's data sync suggests it's the Shroud.
The Templars seem to want it pretty bad all of a sudden. They must know something we don't.
The only thing we know is that we can't go up against Sigma Team alone.
Leave that to me. In the meantime, keep a low profile. Let the Initiate continue to sync the data.
A letter? For me?
Owning the railway wasn't enough. Now Starrick has bought an omnibus company as well. I suppose he wants to control the neighborhood's workers and keep them under his thumb.
Pearl Attaway is Starrick's competitor, is she? Perhaps it's time I went into business.
And Miss Frye, what are your plans?
I studied the history we recovered from the Kenway Mansion's hidden room. I'm off to a certain monument.
A letter? For me?
Listen to me. I have been ordered to keep your rallies off the streets.
No, you must listen to me. The people in this city are in dire need of your assistance. Oh, you are Jacob Frye, are you not? And Miss Frye?
We're at a disadvantage, sir.
Karl Marx, much like you, I am an activist of sorts.
You've got the look of a man who wants something.
Indeed. You've done more for London citizens lately than any endeavor has accomplished in a decade. But those citizens were already well provided for. I challenge you both to help those who really need your assistance, the working people.
An interesting challenge. We accept.
Shouldn't we at least talk about these things for... Sod it. We accept.
I'm organizing a discreet meeting with some like-minded friends to discuss trades unions. Alas, the police seem to have noticed my activities. They've stuck to me like flies on Shizon. In any case, I need you to help me get to the meeting without the interference of the police.
You won't get away with it, you know!
rundown. The usual place.
I'll be there.
You know, I had similar problems with the police in Paris. Well, Paris and Brussels. And also, perhaps Cologne. Our next worthy ally awaits us in a nearby pub. Onwards. No doubt the police already have agents stationed within. I'll wait here until the coast is clear.
Just let me
up. All together now. That'll do.
Slip away and get to the meeting. I do appreciate your assistance in this matter. Only when workers are able to assemble freely and in strength will we be able to achieve the reforms we most assuredly deserve. Might I trouble you to stay nearby until the meeting is over? I fear we may yet meet with some mischief.
Don't you worry.
In God's name, help!
It seems the movement is ever doomed to be betrayed from within.
Help! Somebody!
Hell, that's Marx's hired ruffian! Save me!
Don't escape!
It seems the movement is ever doomed to be betrayed from within. Will you fetch the gentleman back here? I will look him in the eye and ask why.
Are you mad? You're making a big mistake.
We're fast friends now, aren't we? Silence, and I might let
you live. Whatever
you
want!
Don't call for help.
Oh, he got me!
What's all the ruckus, I wonder?
I don't require a reason to end
just
your
say
life.
The word.
Anybody, help me!
I recommend you stop
whatever
struggling.
You want.
What's all that?
Is there a barrow over there? Ear, what's happening?
We're fast friends now, aren't we?
Oh, you got me!
Yes, you! You spare a penny for a veteran of the Light Brigade! The Light Brigade! No! There was even a bloody poem written about us!
I'd rather not hurt you.
Just
don't
say
think
the
I
word.
Won't. Silence, and I might let you live.
Me.
Don't call for help.
Simon, my friend, what possessed you to do this thing? Has the party not taken care of you?
Governor, the mill say any man what joins a union will be put out of work come sun up. How long will the party feed my family for?
If we do not stand together, we are lost. My heart is broken, Simon. Please go. I thank you, my friend. I hope you will continue to aid the struggle when the opportunity presents itself. Poor friend, Frank Morris. His son dropped dead of exhaustion after finishing an 18-hour shift. Frank is consumed by grief. He blames the government for refusing to protect the rights of the worker. I can't blame him for his rage, but I fear his actions have gone too far. He plans to steal a shipment of nitroglycerin and use it to attack the houses of parliament. Killing people and destroying property solves nothing. Democracy is the only road to socialism. Please stop it before he gets himself or anyone else killed. I expect he's on his way into the city.
Steady on. Bloody perfect. Best deal with this before Morris shows up.
Keep moving.
Here's a good horse.
You up.
Whoa, easy.
Who are you?
Mark sent me. Now please, be quiet.
You tell Mark that I don't need his help, or yours. What do you expect me to do? Eat a dog or bite if it wants to open? I don't like being told what to do.
People who don't like you stealing their toys.
We're trapped in here unless you ascend and deal with them. Get your bloody hands off me. Got the nitro back. That must please you.
Not even close. You knew where to find that cart. You must have been tracking shipments for weeks. Tell me where that supply was headed.
I might be able to assist you. Find me in Southwark when you're ready.
Oh.
much brown bread.
He went that way!
They're moving the shipment, but we must go now. There's a carriage on the next corner. If we hide within, they'll drive us right to it.
I'll hide inside it. You're going home.
Oh, don't you get...
These ones get to live, at least until they drive me to this factory.
I'm sorry, but my need is greater than you know. Justice will be done.
Wait, don't...
Morris!
Poor sod.
All right. Gonna smash these crates before anyone else gets any bright ideas.
use you this time!
Mr. Morris, I see. I was afraid it would come to this. He was a good man, but even the best of us can lose our way when blinded by grief. Still, I thank you for preventing a greater tragedy. People injured by their machine. Thank you.
About the reports. Your masters won't be happy if their accounts go up in smoke.
Mother of God, you're right. Follow me, quickly. They should be just inside here. Oh, there they are. Good. They're safe.
Oi! What do you think you're doing? Stop, thief!
That's a girl.
I'm so relieved to have found you. I fear my upcoming meeting is going to be disrupted. Strikebreakers, maybe, or police. Who fear the march of progress.
Ah, so I'm bodyguarding then. Marvelous.
I worry that any agitation will incite terrible violence, so please remove troublemakers without attracting any attention. Wunderbar. Thank you. I must prepare, but I will see you inside shortly.
Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, United Workers. The man we're here to see needs no introduction. But I shall give a fuck away. He has sacrificed so much that we may all benefit. Please pay all reception to Mr. Karl Marx.
Workers, comrades, thank you for your most generous welcome.
Shut up!
Before you today with a heavy heart. England stands at the head of commercial and industrial Europe. In the last two decades, there has been an unheard-of development of industry and unprecedented increase in exports and imports. While these are facts to be celebrated by the property classes, for the workers, very little has changed. You well know under what conditions of shattered health, damaged morals and spiritual ruin this increase of wealth and power was produced for the upper classes. It has become the truth that no perfecting of machinery, no application of science or industry, no improvement of the means of communication, no new colonies, no immigration, no opening up of new markets, no free trade, and no all of these things.
I'd rather not hurt you.
Whatever you want, I'll do it.
Social antagonisms during this epoch of salvation has brought itself almost to the rank of a social institution here in London, the capital of the British Empire. In the annals of world history, this age will be characterized by the more impetuous force of the more so also wage labor is only a transitory subordinate social form which is mind and cheerful heart. It has been said that the House of Commons is a house of landlords. I listen to you today that to capture political power is now the great duty of the working class. We must attempt the political reorganization of the workers if we are...
I recommend you stop struggling.
The workers must go forward in a with a which are considered right in the relations of private persons, shall be recognized as the
ladies
supreme
and gentlemen, this meeting is adjourned. You're all free to go, apart from Mr. Marx. Him we want to have words with.
Stay here. I did this. Yes, quite. It will never be easy, can it?
A great service for the workers of London. I'm confident the reforms we seek cannot be far over the horizon. I don't suppose you'd formally join the Workers' Party.
I'm not much for politics.
He's not much for anything that requires deep thought.
Does that mean you'll join, Comrade Evie?
I'm afraid I have other responsibilities.
Honorary memberships, perhaps.
You don't give up, do you?
We seem to have that in common. Auf Wiedersehen, my friends.
We'll be right back.
Unify fair in all London. Brilliant. Make your way to the start.
Congratulations on your victory.